Don't get beat by the heat. Call Comfort Air AC Electrical and Mechanical for all your AC and electrical needs. We provide residential and commercial services to the North and South Shore and all of the surrounding areas in South Louisiana. Don't be hot this summer. Call Comfort Air today.
Last month in June, we adopted a $14.2 million budget. And I did a little research and I went back in 2003-04 fiscal year, our budget, the city's budget was almost $4 million. So we've come a very long way. We can tout ourselves as being a debt-free city. I think that we're one of the few maybe in the state of Louisiana that can call themselves debt-free. We work very hard to obtain federal and state funds. We've been fairly successful. Some people tell us that we have some members that feel like we spend too much time on grants, but gosh, we have really done well. We're in the process of preparing a $5.8 million grant for sewer improvements. It's part of the water sector program that the state is administering. The pot, the second phase, is $450 million, so we're going to try to get our part of that pot. You know, we were able to receive a lot of money through the COVID Act and some of the recovery money, and we will shortly receive, Ponchatoula has allocated a $2.6 million for COVID relief through the what's called the American Rescue Act. We got $1.3 million last year, and the second phase of it will come probably next month, and another $1.3 million. You know, we had to make some adjustments. These last 2 years have been kind of tough for city government and our employees, you know, with COVID, but we were able to make the adjustments and do things, I think, safely. We made some changes last night at our council meeting. We're real concerned about our security in City Hall, so we have we've contracted for a security audit of our facility, kind of limit access to our City Hall through the side door. Great concerns about that. The ladies up front have great concerns about the people that are coming in and roaming the halls. We also limited access to some of our employees. We have a lot of challenges though this year, this term. Number one, if y'all probably read, we're because we reached the 7,000 population mark plus seven, we're civil service now. Fire and police departments will become civil service. We have appointed the Civil Service Board. We will meet tomorrow, as a matter of fact, with the chairman and representatives from the State Examiner's Office who will walk us through the process. Civil service is very new to me. It's very new to a lot of us in town, but I think that we'll plow our way through it. Also, with the 2020 census information out, our population increased 19.3%. So that puts us in a position to have to redistrict again. Of course, we have to redistrict every 10 years, but with the population that way, it's going to make it a little bit more challenging. We've hired a consultant to work with us on that, and probably should see something probably by the end of the year. Going back to our budget, we were able to put in our budget a 7% pay increase for our employees. We feel like at the time the cost of living index was right at 8%, so we didn't quite match that, and since that it's gone up. We don't see any increases in fees for any services at this point. However, I didn't anticipate that in the budget, but I think American Waste is going to try to increase. They have an annual CPI that we have to adjust to, but I think they're going to be asking for a little bit more. I just got that information yesterday afternoon, so we'll see. I'll tell you that our sales tax collections are very, very good. Our budget is based on $515,000 a month. We got our first month in report yesterday, and we exceeded that amount, so hopefully that's the trend. But a lot of the money that's been out there regarding COVID relief is getting ready to go away. Faith is going to talk to you in a little bit about our downtown revitalization program. It's been very, very successful. Faith has worked very hard. She had an excellent event Friday night. I'll let her tell her about that, tell you all about that and about what's coming soon. We've got a couple of projects that we're going to continue to work on. We're just finishing up our, some of the merchants are here, our West East Pine Street sidewalk project. After a year and a half, I think we finally got it wrapped up. And then you will see in the next couple of weeks where the state is going to have an overlay program from on LA 22 from 7th Street to Dunson Road. And we were told, we've been told that it's probably going to be a night project, so it should be a minimal interruption in traffic because there's a lot of traffic out east. Right, Rose?
Right.
Right, okay. We've been very fortunate, as I mentioned earlier, with the grants, and we've been successful because most of the grants now are either a 75-25, 80-20 match. Because we are in the position that we're in financially, we can pay those fees. In the competitive world and grants, if you pay administrative fees, engineering fees, and your match, or a greater portion of a match, you stand to be in a much, much better position. So we're going to continue with that. I will tell you, we've finished the East Pine Street sidewalk project. We've got two other sidewalk projects that we're working on. One of them is a downtown pedestrian project that's probably about 6 years old. It takes that long. And then we're just finishing up on the, had training in City Hall for the interstate lighting project. That was a $2.4 million project that we had to put up $240,000. We'll do that all the time. It's a state-of-the-art system and can be controlled from City Hall. So we're happy about that. We have included in the budget, you know, new vehicles for the police department, the annual payment for their communications equipment, construction of a record retention room for them. There's so much evidence now. We thought we had, when the old Homestead building was renovated, thought we had enough room, but they have slowly grown out of that. So we're working on that. Our public transportation program is back up. It was down for about a year and a half with COVID. A little disappointed, but we were not able to continue our after-school program for various reasons, and really the school board has taken some of that off of the municipalities, and we do appreciate that. Of course, we had Ida. We had 26 facilities in the city that were damaged. We're working on those, the reimbursement of that. To be able to build back, we've got to front the money, and we still haven't received any funds from FEMA at this point. We're getting very close. Now, there was a lot of attention given to Athletic Park and whether it was going to be able to be salvaged or not, and I'm happy to report that it is. We have a structural report that tells us that the main structure itself is in good shape. As a matter of fact, I'm meeting this afternoon with the engineers that are charged with that project, and we're going to start phasing some things and begin that work. You've heard a lot about our Behringer Road sidewalk project. It's going to happen. It's just taking a long time. And in between that, we're doing an extensive drainage survey in that section of the town. We also have a comprehensive study going on the southwest section for drainage. That seems to be the big thing right now. Of course, when you get these downpours like we had last week with 3.5 inches in an hour's time, it's kind of tough. But we're proud of our fire department and their work. They're going to be adjusting to the civil service form of doing things employment-wise, but they do a great job at their firefighting. I'm going to tell you that we had plenty of work going on, and we're going to continue to do that. I'll be glad to answer any questions. I'm not going to go on long because Faith's got a lot she wants to tell you as well. But one of the things we did, the final thing that we did in the budget, is that we've been talking with the veterans, and we're very sympathetic towards some of what the problems that they've had. So we took the old health unit and we were going to convert it into a counseling center for them, actually just give them the space. Well, it got damaged during the hurricane, and we were able to get FEMA is going to replace the building itself. So we should get started on that very shortly. I'm very pleased to do that for our veterans. I didn't realize there was such a need out there, but there really is. So again, we consider ourselves to be in great shape. We've done a lot. We have a lot to do. We started a project
probably about four or five years ago.
Yeah, and it's the sidewalk that goes from 5th Street all the way down to Wayne on the north side of LA 22. Now we have another project that's been in the making. It's called our Downtown Pedestrian Project, and it is a landscaping, handicap accessibility project. We
want to,
if you take the 100 block of West Hickory Street and visualize that, that's what we want to move on to, the two blocks, one block on each side of the railroad, plus down 6th Street. So we're working on that. It's about a $3 million project. It's been on the books for a while. We do have partial funding for it. It's just that when we get to a point where we can show a visual of it, we're going to do that pretty quick, hopefully.
Don't get beat by the heat. Call Comfort Air AC Electrical and Mechanical for all your AC and electrical needs. There's no problem too big or too small. Our licensed technicians can handle it all. We provide residential and commercial services to the North and South Shore and all of the surrounding areas in South Louisiana. We're licensed, insured, and bonded with over 10 years of providing great customer service to the community. Don't be hot this summer. Call Comfort Air today.